Hi, I'm Brendan Slade. I'm Director of Tools and Embedded Ecosystem at NXP Semiconductor. I'll be talking to you today about our latest LPCXpresso board. It's for the LPC11U68. So the board is here. It's one of our second generation boards. So it has many nice features for evaluating the processor, the 11U68 device, and also for doing some prototyping. The main processor is here. It's our 100-pin package. There's an in-system debug probe here, and I'll talk a bit more about that in just a second. There's many options for expanding and prototyping here. We have Arduino shield connectors along here, Arduino Uno type those are. There's also holes here for the PMOD style expansion if you want to use that. And of course, we also have the standard LPCXpresso expansion connectors, which can be fitted by yourself if you want to use those. And of course, they're compatible with Embed as well. There's a handy little prototype area down here if you want to add some of your own circuitry as well to do some more prototyping work. The in-system debug probe, that's the chip here, and that enables you to exploit all the features of the LPCXpresso IDE. Along with being able to debug the processor in this system here, you can also, with a couple of quick jumper settings, adjust it so that you can use it with an external target. So you can start developing with this board here, and then when you have your own board, you can use this to debug that as well. Also, there's the option to use someone else's probe, and just again, a couple of easy jumper settings, connect your debug probe here, and you're up and running. A few other nice features on the board. We have a reset button and a wake button as well, and we have a tri-color LED, so you can add a little bit more variety to your evaluation code. Finally, there's a test point here so you can easily measure the current consumption of the board during your evaluation work. There's also the USB connection here. These are micro-style USBs. One is for the target connection to the PC for debugging. The other one is so you can connect your other devices here during your code development. So when you have your board, it's very easy to find out how to use it and configure it and debug. So you go to lpcware.com, and here we have a website which explains about the configurations for the various debug options, and it also gives you access to schematics. Once you have that figured out, you can go to the download area for LPCXpresso and download your free version of LPCXpresso. That will enable you to debug code up to 256K bytes and get support from our forums on the same site. And then once you have that installed, you can go and grab a copy of LPC Open 2 for this board, and that's going to give you drivers for the chip level devices, also other supporting drivers for features that are on the Espresso board, and some examples to try out. So let's try out some of those examples now. Now I've loaded LPC Open into my copy of LPCXpresso, and you see all the different projects that come with it. And the easy one to run to show you is the Blinky demo. So as when you load LPC Open from lpcware.com, you just point to the zip file where all the files are, and then LPCXpresso is going to load it all up for you. You can just hit build and build everything. So in this example, I've already compiled it, so I can just hit run here, and then the lights start flashing on my board. The IDE includes all the features you'd expect to find on a modern debug system, and so you can easily mouse over things and look at variables and so on. So in summary, we've seen how easy it is to get started with an LPCXpresso board. So you can visit lpcware.com, download the software. The board is available through nxp.com. Thanks for watching and have fun with the board.